Hello. We recorded this episode of the Fan Show at the Doctor Who Festival on Sunday the 15th of November in front of a live studio audience. It was all going so well until we got the footage home and realised the audio recording was distorted beyond use. We debated pulling the show, but Stuart and Carrie were such great guests and it was so awesome hearing from some of you guys in person that we couldn't bring ourselves to not publish it. So here it is. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget you can switch on the closed captions.
Once Clara had gone into Morpheus, did anyone notice when it cut to Clara's POV? pretty quickly. Yeah, a few people noticed. Yeah, because as soon as that happened, I was like, hang on a minute, Clara doesn't have a camera. Why are we seeing her POV? So I thought that was interesting. So it also kind of left you to be able to be with the Doctor and companion and work out as it was going on.
But there was a great moment where it went into first from Clara's POV when you see the Doctor look at her.
Yeah,
like something's wrong.
Yeah.
Just for a second, he knew there was something not quite right about her.
And it really puts you in their shoes.
The reason she is Smith is in this episode as a person. And, you know, I thought this was a perfect casting for this episode because I'm actually a big fan of Inside Number 9. I don't know if anyone's seen that, but he's also in that, and it's a very experimental series. And I thought, you know, if recently that she is going to be a Doctor, this is the episode to be in. So I love this performance. It's very intriguing in the end as well. What did you guys think?
Yeah, if you want dialed back creepy, there's a few treatments in the finishing series, really. And then I was supposed to see him collaborate with Bob Gates, as again, obviously they're both from League of Gentlemen back in the day, so put various things together over the years. You knew the part was going to be with some really sort of make up sort of talents, which I think they did very well.
He's the perfect person to make you wonder whether he's friend or foe. I was so sort of engaged in the beginning where I was like, I don't know if I'm supposed to be friends with you or not. I wasn't sure. He's. I mean, that just says how great his performance was, that he kept guessing until the very end.
Yeah, I thought it was fantastic. I'm a huge League of Gentlemen fan, so it was just nice to see, like, the third League of Gentlemen boxing Pat Pemberton inside the library and Mark's been in, and even Ben Rose, I know, so it was really nice. I thought it was fantastic, like you say, to get anyone to play a classic, and it felt like a classic Doctor Who villain. It was he's perfect for it, and had this nature of his smile. I mean, I love his posture. 70s, 80s, late 7 classic that I loved him, and I thought Reese was fantastic. Down to the point where he does play that, and we're not sure if he's nice. And then that final scene where he reveals his true plan, when he comes out from my mantle, that just felt real classic, like a trap door opening, and he comes, and it was my plan, and then it wasn't his plan, and so I thought Reese was perfect as well.
Well, this week we had an awesome Sandman. It's pretty disgusting, because, you know, they're made out of snake in your eyes, which wasn't it? Scary as well. I love how they, you know, didn't actually see that much of it in the beginning. They were, you know, in my eyes, actually really scary. I was wondering what you guys thought. What did you guys think of Sandman?
What do you think of Sandman? Everyone thinks. There's a hand straight up there. What do you think of Sandman?
I thought they were really cool. Especially the design was really scary. A big gaping mouth, which looked like it was about to. There's a bit where the guy ran into the room and he was just looking at that, and then suddenly the camera turned around and jump scared me. And I was the one that jumped out of my whole family and sitting there just like, not doing anything. It was really scary.
Right. Not scary anymore.
Yeah, I thought the Sandman were a great aesthetic. They work incredibly well. However, and this is my only complaint about the episode in general. I thought that Mark Gatiss' story was somewhat cliched, and the use of the Sandman was something that we have already seen many times before. In terms of the way that the rest of the team arrive on the space station at the very end, and also the way that the plot played out, it was very much the opposite of the form like the Ark in space, for example. So I felt that the Sandman, as you say, like the way Temple is moving, they look fantastic, they look pretty creepy. I felt they could have been also lit a little bit differently in some shots, especially when they emerged into the ice chamber. I thought the episode could have done a bit better. I'm saying that with Mark Gatiss is wandering around as well, so I don't know what to say. But yeah, I think it was perhaps the weakest episode of Series 9. But apart from that, I think some of them were. I hope it's a sequel.
It's no different.
Sorry.
What do you want to do? Get hit. What do you think of something?
Scary, and they were actually pretty cool.
Yeah. But you were terrified of them, you were scared of them.
Yeah,
if they
were
not
in
front,
I would
have
actually
been
scared.
Oh, so if one was wandering around here, you'd run away.
I'd run away. What did you guys think of the
segment? Yeah, I think effects work best when it's mostly practical news and then CGI on top to enhance. So. Yeah, from that point of view.
It felt like a proper classic Doctor Who monster. Every, like, just every now and again, it's nice to kind of have like a proper classic monster. And I did wake up this morning and have seen my eye and freak out a little bit, which I probably will be doing for the next week or so, until something else in the Doctor Who replaces that. But yeah, but they're great.
Yeah, I think like some people saying, they do feel like classic Doctor Who villains. I thought that was a really good idea. The story kind of felt like a very, almost a cliched classic Doctor Who story. That worked. I mean, that was almost, you know, Rasmus's idea. Doctor Who can go anywhere and do anything, that's the beauty of the show. I mean, it should do anything, you know, like, I love it when you get a crazy different director in and just like, right, I'm making this whole choice, and you know, Mark writes in the script, this is going to happen, it's going to be POV, I love that. Give us a yay if you think it should be more crazy than two stories. Yay! More crazy than two stories.
Very interesting and imaginative episode where we actually get to discover hidden streets in London.
Everyone's got lost and thought, I've never seen this bit before. The truth is, you really did find an extra street.
Ritty is back. Hey, what's wrong? He discovers a tattoo that's come from nowhere and he doesn't remember how he's got it.
I don't know who did this to you, but I do almost certainly know how to find them.
We're going to meet some old friends when we finally enter Trap Street, and somebody is going to have to face the Raven.